Welcome to this week's episode of Go. I'm your host, Sam Numson. Thanks so much for checking out this week's show. We're here at Beattie School of the Arts, where they're gearing up for their musical production of Rock of Ages. Now, a pretty interesting story here. This is the first time this musical has been licensed in BC for performance here in this sort of venue. So coming up on the show, we're going to chat with a couple of actors, some of the students here, about their roles, many of them not even born in the 80s or probably mid-90s. So it's probably a pretty big stretch for them to really involve themselves in these characters and really live in the 80s. But stick around for that. First, we're going to chat with director, instructor here, Brittany. Thanks for coming on the show.
Yeah, thanks for having us. We appreciate it.
Happy to be here. Super cool set. Lots of kind of vintage retro stuff. Guitars behind us. Big focus on rock with this show. What's the show all about?
So the show's a really popular one. It started out on Broadway. It's been running on there for quite a while. People probably most familiar with the Rock of Ages movie with Tom Cruise. So it's pretty much the same thing. We are the first school to do this particular version of it, so it is going to be different. So even if you feel you've never or you've already seen it before, come on out anyway, because it is different. It's the story of just a small town girl who ends up moving to Los Angeles, and she goes there for fame and stardom, and finds that it might not be as easy to achieve as she thinks it is. So as she goes across and does her little journey through LA, she comes across a variety of different characters that both help her and hinder her on her path. And as she goes through, she starts to realize that maybe there are other things that are a bit more important than fame and stardom. And the end, you'll just have to come see for yourself.
Yes, we'll have to find out. I mentioned earlier in the show that these students weren't born in the 80s, but they're really having to tap into that sort of music in the era. So what's that been like, teaching them about that, taking them there?
So it's been really fun and really interesting to teach them about that. Like you said, they a lot of them are familiar with the songs, but only because they've heard them on the radio or their parents are familiar with them, their grandparents. They don't really have a personal connection to those sorts of songs coming into this. So now they could probably say that they do have quite the connection to them. And it was a bit of an experience getting them to just let go and have some fun and put the energy into singing these songs. I actually had to put earplugs in all of them once and just get them to focus on singing and the pure fun and enjoyment and excitement of these sorts of songs, because they can't be sung if you don't have that passion and that enthusiasm. So it was a really great journey. It was a really fun experience for all of them to get to learn this new sorts of genre and bring these old classics back to life.
A lot of fun, a lot of songs, kind of flashiness as well, but there's a story here. What are people taking away, audience members, from this kind of as a theme or a story?
I would say the big theme of this one is just forming connections and what sorts of connections are the most important to you. So it touches upon family connections, romantic connections, and just a personal connection, learning to identify what's important to you, and overcoming obstacles would be the big one. So it's a really inspirational story. It's an inspirational play. So it's for all ages. So bring the young ones, bring the teenagers, bring grandma, grandpa. It will be a really good experience for everybody.
Perfect. Again, yeah. It's happening June 8th through 11th here in the Black Box Theater at the JP campus of the Beattie School of the Arts, right?
You got it, yeah.
Perfect. Stick around, because we're going to chat with a couple of the cast members coming up in the show, and Brittany one more time, so stay tuned for that. First, though, Encore Senior Society is presenting their annual Senior Symposium, and we got a behind-the-scenes look. These drums are going to get a workout here in the Black Box Theater at Beattie School of the Arts, the JP campus, when Rock of Ages hits the stage here, courtesy of the Senior Musical Theater class. So Dustin joining us now. Thanks for coming on the show.
Thank you for having me.
You're all decked out in kind of 80s rock garb. Take us through what you're looking forward to with regard to this performance. People know it. People love it. What are you looking forward to?
I'm looking forward to, like, the audience just, like, getting pumped because they remember that song from the 80s, or, like, just all the awesome choreo that we have planned too, because it's not like stereotypical musical theater. It's not like, oh yeah, we're singing the lyrics, we're dancing the lyrics. No, it's like, we're rocking out. It's fun.
So how do you prepare for that? Are you listening to these songs kind of in your own time, or are you a fan of the 80s classic rock anyway?
All the above. Okay. I am a fan, and I've been listening to, like, I made a playlist that has all the songs that we're doing, and I'm listening to it nonstop.
So talk about the role that you play within this musical. We've got a mic stand here behind us. You said you spend a lot of time there.
Oh, yeah. I'm Joey Primo. That's Primo as in the tomato sauce, because I'm saucy. Okay. But, like, he's the stereotypical rocker. He's, like, all for it. He's, like, oh, I want to be a big rock star. I want to, like, get all the money. And, like, so he's becomes the new singer of an awesome band. And it's just great.
Have you ever wanted to be kind of a rock star musician? Okay, yes, you're nodding. So what's it like to kind of live out your dream through this performance?
It's actually the coolest thing ever, because, like, you you kind of get that vibe. Like, you can watch movies and you can like see like, oh, that'd be cool to dress as for like Halloween or something. But actually being able to like play that part, like being able to be that, is so like, it's breathtaking. Like, it's like, is this real life? And as you can see, I kind of adapted into my normal talk, too.
Yeah. You're totally in character. What do you think people will enjoy about this show? Obviously, some may be familiar with it, some may be new to it, but what do you think the takeaway is with regard to the show?
Well, I think people are definitely going to enjoy lots of, like, the references and the jokes. But it's definitely, like, fight for what's right. Like, fight for what you believe in. That's, like, the main takeaway that I think should come from it.
Thanks for coming on the show, Dustin.
Thank you.
Our pleasure. Stick around. There's more Go coming up here only on Shaw TV. Rock on. June 8th through 11th here at the Beattie School of the Arts JP Campus Black Box Theater. 80s classic rock is going to be taking center stage as part of Rock of Ages happening here as part of the senior musical theater class.
Mm-hmm.
Musical. That was a mouthful. Talk about what this musical is about for those who don't know, who aren't familiar with it.
Okay, well, it's basically taking you back to the 1980s, like mid to late 1980s, and it's all about this one bar on the main strip, and it's all about keeping the rock and stuff like that, and then these people try and take it away, and it's all about fighting for bringing, like, keeping inside the city.
Okay.
So it's all about the conflict there, and it's also like there's love and all that added in there as well.
Love and stuff, yeah. This is obviously centered around lots of 80s classic rock.
Yeah.
You weren't alive in the 80s.
No.
So how are you tapping into that?
Well, it's been an experience. One of the things I love about the school is it always gives me an opportunity to like try something completely different. And it's like, I don't listen to 1980s music, but doing this has given me an opportunity to actually listen to the music and have a lot of fun with it. And I know the lyrics to all these songs now that I didn't know before. And now like I hear them all over the place and it's just fun to rock out. So
are you getting a new appreciation for this music? Maybe discovering some other artists from that time period?
Yeah, definitely. My parents, obviously, they listen to this sort of thing as well. So, I mean, it works out really well because, like, then I get to connect with them on a different level as well because, like, I can talk to them about songs and stuff like this and, like, find other music that's also really good from the time. It's just a good experience overall, like, because, like I said before, just new things is overall just really awesome.
What do you like about the performing arts, being part of the musical, whether it's this one or others? What are you getting out of it?
I get to make people laugh, and I guess that's, like, the thing that makes me happiest in life is like entertaining people and making people happy.
Thanks for coming on the show, Fraser.
All right, thank you.
No problem. And you can see Fraser and some of his classmates here from Beattie School of the Arts June 8th through 11th here at the Black Box Theater. We're going to throw some information on the bottom of the screen as well, so you can find that there. Up next, though, we're going to throw it over to new volunteer reporter Mona. She's over at Parkcrest Elementary with a story on a new environmental project. You're watching Go only on Shaw TV here from the Beattie School of the Arts. Rehearsals are underway for Rock of Ages happening June 8th through 11th here at the Black Box Theater. Sarah joining us now. Thanks for coming on the show.
Hi, thank you for having me.
Our pleasure. So I understand you kind of play the villain or the fun police in this show. Talk about your role.
Yeah, I am a German woman who comes in and I hate rock and roll. I hate dirty things. So I want to make the streets all clean and I want to actually make a Foot Locker athletic wear store. That is that's my absolute dream. To like get rid of this place, so everyone basically is fighting against me, so I'm trying to get the mayor to sell his land to me. So yeah.
How does it feel playing the person that everyone's supposed to hate? What's that like for you?
It's pretty fun because first of all, I have a German accent, so that's pretty fun. I had to learn the German accent for this role, and then I also have a son, and I yell at my son all the time, and I yell at everyone all the time. So some people it's like, oh, you got to be louder, but for me it's like, oh, you're like super loud already.
Yeah.
Just because of how like, because I have to yell everything because I'm always angry. So
okay.
It's kind
now,
of fun.
Whether you're German or not, or whether you like the music in reality or not, are you tapping into some sort of yourself in this role? Do you identify with parts of your character or not really?
Not super a lot. I don't really get angry like compared to my character, but she's really fun to play still. So it's not hard to play this character. So
now, obviously, we're in the middle of rehearsals. You guys have been working on this for a long time. We're close to the opening night. What's it like now? How are things going as far as rehearsing?
It's really good because we've come so far, but like at the same time you're like, oh no, like I don't know if I'm gonna mess up at the end of the show, but like it's really exciting. So like you've got that kind of mixture of like, are we gonna be like ready in time even though we're already pretty much ready, or like am I going to mess up and things like that. So, yeah.
Now, little mistakes happen, obviously. I was in high school theater as well. It happens. That's part of the fun. But yeah. What are you looking forward to most with regard to this production?
I think just, like, this is my last show, and I've been in a few shows here at Beattie, and I'm just looking forward to, like, acting on stage with all the people that I've known for, like, 12 years before I actually graduate. So, yeah, that'll be fun.
Thanks for coming on the show, Sarah.
Yeah, thank you for having me. Yeah.
Happy to be here. And of course, you can come down and check out Rock of Ages happening here at the Beattie School of the Arts in the Black Box Theater. It's on the JP campus, which is on 9th. So make sure to come by there June 8th through 11th. We're going to throw a link here on the bottom of the screen as well for all the information you'll need. Stick around. You're watching Go Only on Shaw TV. You're watching Go Only on Shaw TV. We've been down here at the Beattie School of the Arts taking in a rehearsal for Rock of Ages coming June 8th through 11th here at the Black Box Theater. We're going to throw the link on the bottom of the screen in case you've missed it throughout the show to come and check it out for yourself. Brittany joining us again, the director and teacher here. If people do want to kind of come down and check things out, when can they catch it? How can they check out the show?
So tickets are available right now at both Beattie campuses. They're also available by my school district email. And right now for the week of the show, we are doing personal delivery for two tickets or more to houses. So if you find that you just can't make it down and you've got no way to come get a ticket, we'll bring the tickets to you. So it's showing June 8th to 11th. 6 o'clock is the curtain time, so you have to be there for then. We've got a variety of different things. We're doing a guitar raffle every night. We have a silent auction with a diamond ring donated from Michael Hill. We also have a concession stand and a rock star photo booth.
Perfect. Thanks for coming on the show, Brittany.
Yeah, thank you for having us. We appreciate it.
Happy to be here and always supporting the arts. That is it for this week's episode of Go. Thank you so much for watching. We're, again, going to throw the links here on the bottom of the screen for all of the ticketing information, the date, the time, everything you'll need to know is going to be right here. And Brittany also mentioned you can send her an email if you'd like to request tickets that way. So we'll throw that on the bottom as well. We're all online at Shaw TV Kamloops on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. We'd love to interact with you. If you check out the show, why not share a photo or two with us? We'd love to see them. You can also email us at go_kamloops@shaw.ca if you have any questions, concerns, or comments. Again, I've been your host, Sam Nelson. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you next time.